Okay, in this video I'm going to continue on with exercise 2b of the book Fundamental Applied Mathematics. We're on page number 48 and you can read the question yourself. So let's start out. The first thing we do, of course, is draw our speed time diagram. And I've just drawn this first straight out because it says that a car accelerates from rest. If it starts at rest, t equals 0, its also velocity is equal to 0, so it starts here. After 12 seconds we're told it has a velocity or a speed of 24. Because the acceleration is constant, you can draw them, connect them by a straight line. And then it told you it immediately decelerates to 15 meters per second. Wrong, after 15 seconds to 0 meters per second. So what's the distance? Well, the distance covered is the area underneath the curve. This is something I introduced in exercise 2A. So that's a triangle. Its area is half the base by the perpendicular height. So a half times 12, because that's the distance here between 0 and 12, times 24, so that's equal to 144 meters. So there, 144 meters. Area or part 2, well, the total distance on the base is 15 minus 12 is equal to 3 seconds, so it's half 3 times the perpendicular height. Sorry, you couldn't see that. Half 3 times the perpendicular height, which is 24. So that's 12 times 3 is equal to 36 meters. Like that. So the total area is the sum of the two areas, which is 180 meters. And that's the total distance, 180 meters. That's correct. Now, we should know that to get the speed, you have the formula distance, speed, time, like this. And to get the average, you say the total distance, total speed, total time. So to get the average speed, we say that it's the total distance of 180 meters divided by the total time, which is 15 seconds, giving us 12 meters per second. Let's just check that at the back of the book. Place. Sorry about that now. 12 meters per second, and that's correct. So that was reasonably straightforward. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe to my channel and pass it on to your friends.